we'll see if the floodgates open. Dirk's the shot. Go! Yes, sir! Shane Gersich makes it two!
Might have been a bye week, but there's still no lack of things to talk about tonight here on North Dakota Hockey with Brad Berry. I'm your host, Alex Heinert, and coming up, we're going to take you to Riverside Park for UND's annual outdoor practice, look ahead to the resumption of NCHC play against Western Michigan this weekend, and talk recruiting, the NHL, and much more with the head coach of North Dakota men's hockey, Brad Berry. And Brad, this is the first time in 2017 you had an open weekend, six straight weekends of play coming in. I know you guys haven't been sitting on your hands by any stretch, but was it nice to get a week off from games this week?
Yeah, it was. I'm glad you said open weekend. It wasn't an off weekend, and we did a lot of things here, but gave our players a chance to reset mentally and physically. And, coming back, we should be ready to go as far as having a lot of energy for the final push of the season.
Now, you mentioned that final push. If you really could put your bye week any place in the season, would this be the spot you would pick?
Absolutely. I know this is a time of year that, it's kind of the long days of the winter going into the springtime, and guys see the playoffs around the corner, and this is a time of year too where guys are banged up a little bit. It gives a good chance to recuperate and get healthy again.
Yeah, you mentioned the guys being banged up. Some of those injuries have been a little bit more serious than others. How important has it been to give them some rest but also stay sharp with the week ahead coming up?
It's very important. We had to manage this, and we've been through this the last few years as far as how we want to give guys days off versus work days, and we've managed it pretty good as far as getting the rest to work ratio through this week.
Yeah, certainly both of those things important. Like I say, laughter, by the way, the best medicine for some of that stuff. There was a lot of that going on this past week at Riverside Park for UND's annual outdoor practice. We're going to take you there and much more after the break.
North Dakota Hockey with Brad Berry on Midco Sports Network is presented by the University of North Dakota.
Welcome back. Well, in what's become a bi-week tradition, North Dakota Hockey left the friendly confines of Ralph Engelstad Arena last Thursday afternoon and took to the open air of Riverside Park for their annual outdoor practice. Our Midco SN crew was there for the highlights. Well, what a great tradition that clearly the guys have a pretty good time with. How did this tradition get started?
Well, I think a few years back, it started in the second half of the year where, you know, you have that off week and there's things that you want to try to stay fresh with and something a little bit different. And obviously being in North Dakota, the outdoor rinks are a big thing on player development for youth hockey. And, you know, you kind of go back to your youth days of going to the outdoor rink, and our guys absolutely love that day when they go outside.
Yeah, this is such a cool thing for this program, a neat throwback to those times of the kids going up and going out to the pond and making it happen after school. Just talk about how this is another cool cultural thing here at the University of North Dakota, you guys
think. Well, obviously, you know, we have a lot of players that grew up from around the area or the region here that grew up on the outdoor rink, so it's second nature for them to go outside. But, you know, we have some players from outside the area that, they grew up in areas that don't have outdoor rinks, and it's kind of neat and special for them. And I know our guys, obviously we go out there and we practice and do a few drills, and then we get into a scrimmage, and our guys absolutely love it because it's a way to try to release themselves a little bit and get back to the younger days, and again, having a mental break of what we do on a daily basis.
Yeah, that certainly was the case for the guys last week. Here's what they had to say about their annual outdoor experience.
Yeah, it's awesome. I mean, we got the bye week here, so we're able to come out here and have some fun with the boys, you know, create some more memories outdoors, so it's a lot of fun.
Goose doesn't know what he's doing out here. He looks lost. It's his fourth outdoor game. You think you know what he's doing, but I don't know.
The local boys played pond hockey a lot, but I guess not.
Anytime you extend, you're worried about pulling something, but no, it's a good time. Guys are having fun out here. Yeah, just trying to keep moving and stay warm. I think it's just the atmosphere. You kind of go back to your kid days and jumping out on the pond. That was kind of the highlight of the day. I remember getting off school and just kind of running over to the pond, and it didn't matter how cold it was. You just bundled up and had fun with it, so it brings back those kind of memories.
I'm giving the W to the local guys. Just too much skill from the guys in Grand Forks. We have the grit and determination to win those types of games. Each year, it goes by so quick, but you got to cherish these moments. You get to get out of the rink and have a fun practice outdoors.
Good stuff from the guys. I was having a tough time asking questions. My face was frozen. It was about 8 degrees, not counting the winds this past week. In related news, I noticed the coaches were not out there. Not questioning the toughness of you guys.
Well, we would have been out there, but we were using our time otherwise. All three of us were on the road here, and that's part of the off week or the open week is getting some work done on the recruiting trail. So we let the guys go on their own, and again, they managed. Our leaders did a great job of organizing it.
Yeah, a lot of faith in those guys running things well, certainly, Coach. Well, we're going to talk about that recruiting trail when we come back. Much more to come with the head coach here on North Dakota Hockey with Brad Berry after the break. Welcome back. Well, as we don't have any games to recap, we thought we'd kind of take this conversation in a couple different directions now for the next couple of minutes, Coach. And obviously with no games, a chance for you and your staff to get out onto the recruiting trail. What updates can you tell us from the recruiting trail this past
week? Well, you know what? It's a good chance to get out in the second half of the year and, try to identify good young talent again, but also kind of watch and evaluate some of our committed young players playing in their various leagues too. So, you know, it's a great way to try to reestablish connection with our current committed players and going out and try to identify new talent.
Yeah. How many miles do you and your staff put on in any given year like this?
You know what? I'm not going to probably guess, but it's a lot between flying and driving. It's quite a bit, and it's pretty spontaneous too. You know, we've usually through a year we have our set trips or tournaments that we go see, but you know, it might be a spontaneous trip where you go down and you drive 2-3 hours to come watch a game and then drive back that same night. So again, there's a lot of spontaneity in the recruiting trail, and that's part of the process.
Yeah, every coach that I know has a great recruiting anecdote or story or two. What's your favorite recruiting story from over the years?
Well, I mean, I always go back to the one where we're driving back from Denver and we hit the ditch and about 10 hours away, we ended up hitting a ditch, and we ended up driving the rest of the way on a car that didn't look very well, and we made it back. But most recently I was on the road here, and you always try to look at the weather channel before you go somewhere, and it seems like when I went on the, every time I go on the road this year, it snows or you're white knuckling it somehow, and again, it's just battling through the adversity of the weather, and that's all part of recruiting.
Yeah, goodness, not a very fun part of the process, certainly. This has been a process in terms of recruiting and how things are done with college hockey and the pros and how these kids are drafted that it maybe has been discussed, maybe being adjusted the last couple of seasons. How do you feel the process? Do you feel like it works well? Does it need some change? What do you think about this?
Yeah, you know what? I think it's been good in the fact that, you get on the road and you identify some talent, you try to project, you know, when they're going to come in. And it seems like recruiting has gotten so much younger now. And, you know, we're trying to identify talent when they can come in and make an impact. And I know the NHL from their side of it, you know, they're trying to draft players at a certain age too. So it's something that you really have to drill down on. And in order to be good every year, you have to make sure that you do your due diligence and get on the road and make sure that you're recruiting the right players.
Yeah, well, you've certainly done a great job of that, of course, with so many guys you've recruited that have moved on to NHL careers. And speaking of which, Paul Ledoux made his debut for the LA Kings last week, the eighth player now from North Dakota to debut in the National Hockey League this season, the fourth from last year's team alone. That's an incredible number and incredible accomplishment for these kids.
Yeah, you know what, it says a lot about what they've done, you know, when they got to North Dakota. You know, obviously we identified their talent, but from there on in, it's all up to them as far as how they manage their time here and set themselves up for the next level, and they did that. We're so proud of all our guys, and you know, especially Paul Ledoux, who finally got a chance to play here, and you knew it was a matter of time when he left here that he would get his first shot, and he did. And I think the second game he played, he got an assist, and he's well on his way. But again, we're proud of all our guys that go through our program, not only the guys that get to the NHL, but go on and get great degrees and get a great job in the working environment.
Yeah, how is it for you as a coaching staff to keep track of these guys? You're so busy during the regular season. Is it tough to kind of keep tabs on what's happening out there?
Yeah, it is a little bit, but again, you know, it's something that, you know, through social media or through texts or through phone calls, it's pretty easy to do. The other thing is they keep track of us pretty well. Like, we always, after every weekend, they text us, call us, wish us luck, different things. So as much as we're keeping track of them, they're keeping pretty good track of us.
Yeah, certainly. Paul, again, the 12th member of the NCHC to make their debut this season. Again, eight of those coming from North Dakota. Really impressive stuff there. Looking ahead, and speaking of the NCHC, you get to dip back into conference play this week. Western Michigan, the opponent, is a Bronco team that has really turned things around this year, sixth right now in the pairwise. What has been the biggest key to them making this leap this season?
I think depth of their group. I think before, you know, they had good teams, but they don't nearly have the depth as they have now. And, you know, what kind of strikes me, the strength of their team is their forward group that are extremely quick. They transition pucks fast. They play an offensive game. So they've added depth up front. Their goaltending, you know, has become very good too. So again, they've gotten better over the course of the last year or two. And again, you know, Danny Murray's done a great job with the program.
You split with this team back in December in Grand Forks. What did you learn from that series?
Well, you know what, we came out Friday, and I think we beat them 5-1 on Friday, and we were pretty aggressive in our mentality of getting pucks and bodies to the net. On Saturday, probably not as much. I know Tyson Jost left for the World Juniors that game, and we didn't have him in the lineup. So again, it's not about one guy in our group. Obviously, we're a team that wins together. It's about collectively having that effort that we did on Friday night here back here in December.
Yeah, you mentioned Tyson Jost. He's one of those guys that have been on the off the ice the last couple of weeks. Do you feel like you will have a full squad come this weekend?
I believe for sure we'd have a lot of our guys available. Obviously, it's early in the week here and we're going through it. And, you know, it seems like every week we wait till the very last second to put guys in the lineup. But again, that's the way we do things, to make sure they're 100% ready to go. And I firmly believe we'll have pretty close to a full lineup this weekend.
Well, a big couple of games certainly coming in. Kalamazoo, Coach, best of luck out there. Safe travels. We'll talk to you about it next week.
Thanks, Alex.
Cool. Brad Berry. When we come back, we're going to continue the conversation about North Dakota hockey with Grand Forks Herald beat writer Brad Schlossman. That's next. Welcome back. Well, we're joined now by college hockey beat writer, now in his 12th season of covering North Dakota hockey for the Grand Forks Herald, Mr. Brad Schlossman. And Brad, it doesn't seem like that long ago that we were talking in this building about the season ahead and the preview of the year. And now there's only three weekends left in the regular season. Unbelievable that it's gone by like
this. It goes by crazy fast every year. It seems like before you know it, you're at crunch time. And here we are checking the pairwise every night and seeing where UND's at.
Yeah, despite the fact that there are only three weekend series left, the season for North Dakota is still very much up for grabs. The story really hasn't yet been written on this team.
Oh, for sure. You know, I think that's one of the intriguing parts is right now they sit in a spot in the NCHC standings where they could be at home or on the road. That they've been at home for, what, 14 straight years, and they're trying to keep that streak going. Right now they would be in the NCAA tournament if the season ended today, but they could also easily drop right out of that mix too. So, you know, every game is so big from here on out just because of where they sit both league-wise and in the national picture.
Yeah. As we look back over this season so far, and as we just said, it's still pretty open-ended, but what do you think has been the main narrative for this North Dakota team this year?
Well, I think a couple things. I think you can see the talent in their top-end players. see what they can do, and they have the potential to take over on a nightly basis. The other one has been inconsistency. They haven't been able to really string together a long stretch of wins outside the first five to start the year. Other than that, they really haven't been able to put together a big streak, and I think that's one of the intriguing parts about this team is that their best may still yet be to come. Yeah. And they have had a lot of injuries to key players. I think coming into the year, we knew that they would be heavily relied upon for those top guys to produce. And every one of those top guys outside Shane Gersich has been hurt this year at times. So we really haven't seen this full team together too often.
Yeah, I think that's been an underrated part about this season, is that there have been so many moments where guys have been out that's really kind of hurt the team as a whole. It has allowed, though, some of the younger guys to develop. 19 underclassmen on this team. Who do you think has improved the most from the start of the season to what you see now?
Oh, you know, like one of the guys that jumps out to me is a guy like Andrew Pesky, a defenseman, you know, and even Casey Johnson you could throw in there. But the last couple weeks, Andrew Pesky's been really good. And at the start of the season, the coaching staff was almost hiding those freshman defensemen with their minutes, and now he doesn't seem to be doing that at all. These guys have been forced to play minutes at times, and I think that's helped their development, and I think both those young D-men have come a long way since the start of the season. They still have a long way to go, but from where they were at the start of the season till now, you can definitely tell a major difference.
Yeah, certainly from a long-term perspective, that's only going to help this North Dakota
team
moving forward. As we look at the big picture right now, with 3 weeks to go, North Dakota pretty much mathematically eliminated from retaining the Penrose Cup for a third straight season. But again, home ice still very much out there. 18 points available for this team over these next six games. Where do you... what do you think this team needs to do to ensure home ice in the NCHC?
Well, I think this weekend at Western Michigan is going to be the biggest weekend they have the rest of the regular season, because it's a great chance for them to move up in the pairwise. They won't have an opportunity like this to make such a jump the rest of the regular season. And also, this is a team sitting above them in the standings. I just think this is a huge series, but they need to find some consistency. They need to be able to generate some offense. In some of the games they've lost, they've had lots of chances and haven't been able to finish. They need to finish those chances and stay healthy. Keep their guys in the lineup, and maybe that'll build some chemistry.
Yeah, by my math, 38 points has been the average total of the team in fourth place these last couple seasons in the NCHC. UND's at 26 right now. Of course, 12 more would get them there. So 4-2 against this group of teams that they've gone 4-2 against this season, and they're going to find themselves back at their off. Any reason why they can't do that?
No, I think, like I said, I think we haven't seen this team's best yet this year. I think they're trending that way. You may not feel that way the way the results have played out, but if you watch how they've played the last few weeks, I really do think that they're trending that way, and we'll see their best soon.
Yeah, Brad, you mentioned a little bit ago that this team certainly has great opportunity to reach a 15th straight NCAA tournament. Their pairwise record, a big reason for that, because they've played such a tough schedule. Do you think that this team has got what it takes to make it into the NCAAs, and do you think they can make some noise if so?
For sure. That's one thing that stands out to me about this year, is that there really isn't a super dominant team or a group of teams. Like last year, I thought there was a group of five that kind of separated themselves. And, you know, going into play in North Dakota last year, most teams were undergunned. You know, they weren't going to be able to beat North Dakota. This year, it's wide open. So getting a tournament, and anything can happen. I think this is one year where anyone that's in the tournament has the potential to win it. And that's what makes it intriguing.
Exactly. And that's college hockey playoffs are fun anyway, especially now this year coming up. We look forward to it, Brad. Thanks so much for the time. Enjoy the last couple weeks of the season.
For sure.
Brad Schlossman of the Grand Forks Herald. Be sure to check him out on the College Hockey Today podcast with Nate Ewell, wherever you get your podcasts from. We're back in a moment to wrap things up this week on North Dakota Hockey with Brad Berry. Stick around.
North Dakota Hockey with Brad Berry on Midco Sports Network is presented by the University of North Dakota.
North Dakota gets back to business this weekend with a trip to Kalamazoo to take on the Broncos of Western Michigan. UND has never dropped points at Lawson Arena and are a perfect 8-0-0 since their first meeting in 1997, but Western is 9-2-3 on home ice this year. Friday's game can be seen at 6 p.m. on CBS Sports Network, while Saturday is also a 6 o'clock start on NCHC TV. We'll have all the highlights from the zoo next Tuesday night on our next edition of North Dakota Hockey with Brad Berry. Until then, I'm Alex Heinert. Thanks for watching.